All right, well guys, we got a pretty good amount of rain last night here, so pretty much all the big creeks around here are high and unfishable. So I came out here to this small stream today to do some native fishing. This is about the only stream that's in good shape. Me, Dan, and Chad are planning to head up to a creek about an hour north of here. We're pretty sure that's gonna be in good shape by this evening. So we're gonna go up there tonight, give that a try. But for today, like I said, I'm here on this native stream. Been here a few times so far this spring and it's been fishing pretty good. So I'm gonna give it a try today, see what happens. And you gotta love fishing for these natives. They definitely live in some pretty cool places. Some pretty big boulders and waterfalls here on this creek, and definitely some pretty cool scenery. So I'm gonna get a nymph tide on here and see if I can't get into some of these trout here. Oh, I had a fish there, guys. There he is. Beautiful little native brookie on the lively legs. Just gonna wet my hand here so I can handle this fish safely. There he is, guys. Beautiful fish, guys. And there he goes. Beautiful hole here next to this big boulder, and should be some more fish in there, so we'll see if we can get any more out of there. There he is again. Oh, I just had him. He came right off. I had him up there at the top in that faster moving water. There we go. Oh, I had him again. It's the only thing about fishing for natives is you lose a lot of fish. Oh yeah, that's a good fish. Real good fish. Oh yeah. Oh. Got him. That has to be the nicest native brookie I've caught out of this stream. Definitely the biggest of today. Beautiful. Just gently take that hook out, and there he is. What a beautiful fish, guys. Let's get him back. Well guys, I got chased back to the truck here by some pretty heavy rain. I stayed out there fishing in it for a while, but I really didn't catch much today. I guess I only landed two trout and missed or lost maybe three or four others, which I had fun, but for native fishing here at this stream, that was a little slow. So I don't know, we'll see what this rain does. This is not really gonna be the end of this video, I guess. I'll either be out tonight, if the creek's gonna be okay, me, Dan, and Chad. And then hopefully be out again tomorrow if the creeks around here are okay, which I don't know if they will be. This rain this spring has been tough on us. It's been pretty relentless. So hopefully it'll let up here and we'll get some good conditions here later today or tomorrow, or if not, next week. So thank you guys for watching, and stay tuned for the rest of this video. There's more to come. All right, what's up, guys? It's later on the same day, and picking up Dan here from work. It is 4:30 right now. He got out of work a half hour early. We're driving about an hour and 20 minutes away. We're gonna meet Chad up there and do some fishing here for this evening until dark. We're hoping the creek's in good condition. Apparently Chad's checking it out right now, so Dan's getting his stuff out of his car, and I'm gonna hear from Dan what Chad had to say about the creek. So hopefully it's in good shape, and if all is well, we'll be up there fishing this evening. Oh yeah, here we go.
Everything here today, boys.
Shout out to Chad.
Hopefully.
Checking out service for us.
I know where to go if we, well, if it's unfishable.
We got dinner, after work dinner, and we better leave now.
Better get out of here.
Yep. So we made it here to the spot.
The spot.
We got myself, Dan, and Chad. Chad's got 4 fish on the board already before me and Dan got here. We got some real nice water out here. Well, Dan.
Well, Grant.
Nice hat.
Oh, this whole thing? Had it for years.
What do we got going on?
Putting a pheasant tail joint on right now.
Pheasant tail?
Yeah, they said put something bright on, but I decided to put something brown on.
Chad's fishing a real nice pool out here. All right, this little run right here produced 2 fish.
Yeah, some, I can't get it off. It's off.
Came off?
Yeah.
Hey, nice.
Thanks, boss.
They're good looking little fish.
Yeah.
The ones I like caught.
If I'm gonna catch like a 12-inch stock trout, I'd almost, I'd rather catch that.
Yeah. The brookies don't have a lot of color, but the brown trout do.
The fact that there's
so you caught
brown.
You caught 2 browns and 2 brooks, right?
Yep.
You said?
Yep.
I caught a brook, and now Dan caught a brown.
I didn't catch many browns this year, but...
We'll sneak up on them today.
Yep.
Yeah, that's the key, I think. Well, Dan, we got some fish rising here, right?
1 or 2. 1 or 2. Mainly 1.
We're going to be putting on a Lake Cahill, right?
Yeah.
Or is that what you're going with or not?
No, that's the plan.
Yeah, there was that fish rising. Yep.
Up top or the one I just...
The same one. There was another one, the little swirl, yep. The one I saw up real high was a...
That, it was right there.
Yeah. Yep, there was that one up higher again. They're in there.
There was that one that was real close that you said slurp.
Yeah. Well, I wasn't filming for that, but that was pretty crazy.
Dan
threw the Cahill in. About the first cast, he got it up to that fish.
Fishing tip. Tie. Better than I did it. Ripped it right off. I could tell it. Yeah.
It had it in its mouth. I'm sure it did.
It hit it so freaking. I thought it. Look, it hit like it was a refusal.
Yeah.
You know how they slap it?
Yeah.
But it took my fly right off, and it definitely didn't cut it. It untied, which makes me a sucker.
All right, well, this one.
So I'll catch that fish and then get my fly back.
Yeah, that'd be pretty awesome, actually.
I don't think I've ever done that.
Nice.
Nice wild brown. Come up here quick.
So we had all these fish here that were rising that that Dan was fishing for. And then some of them kind of started feeding again after they slowed down, and Chad got this one. That's a nice fish.
It is.
That's pretty cool.
Not too bad. A little bit of dry fly action.
Yeah, that's cool to get one on the surface like that. Dan missed that one earlier, but that's the first one we landed on the surface, and there you go.
I think we're throwing a couple sizes too big, but they don't really care.
Yep. Was that the same fish that we saw rise there just a couple minutes ago?
I think so.
Yeah, same spot.
Yeah.
Nice.
He hammered it too.
Nice. Yeah, I wasn't looking. It was right after I started walking
right
down.
You turned around.
Yeah.
Brown.
Here, him, bro.
Doesn't look like that good up there, Dan.
It's just hard to access. It's not worth the time. We don't have the time anyway.
Yeah. Well, folks, unfortunately, I was not filming, but Chad just caught another brown.
It was a little bit smaller than the last one, probably.
Yeah.
You know, the usual.
I got a couple good pictures, I think. Yeah.
It falling out of my hands.
Yeah, the last picture, it's in midair falling out.
You know, this is the one time where I don't stand in the slow water all night. What happens?
That's typically your move, but not tonight.
If I see a rise, yeah.
Yeah.
No.
Well, the ones before we got here were, we caught on.
No, this one was I caught that one in the middle back there that wasn't a rise. He just took it. All about that blind cast.
Yep.
Maybe we should go back down to the other stuff then.
Yeah.
I better would. Chad's beginning the wrap up, man.
Chad.
I'm not good on camera.
Chad caught a lot of fish tonight.
Yeah, Chad caught.
Would you end up with like 8 or 9?
I think seven.
Seven.
Couple chubs.
You hyped him up.
Yeah.
Best night I've had in a while. I'll take it.
Hey, that was fun.
Yeah.
Pretty nice spot here. We all agree.
Yeah. Too bad no one knows where we are.
Yeah, we can't tell them where we are, but.
Backcountry.
Yeah. We were talking about this earlier, how we haven't done well recently here, but yeah. I think tonight reminded us why we like it here.
Oh yeah. We'll
good,
be back.
Yeah.
Courtesy of Chad Crick.
Yep. All right. See you, folks.
See ya, dudes.